So we're on our way. Where are we going today, Steve?
We're going to the Babcock Ranch Preserve Tour, I think it is. So, okay. It'll be quite fun.
Evidently, it's an old school bus, and you go through swamps and you see lots of animals, so we'll see. It's in the middle of absolutely nowhere. I think it may be farmland, some of it, I think. But it's interesting because they had Hurricane Ian through last September, which was September 22, and we're now in May 23. And it's amazing how, there's some cows. A lot of trees have come down, but everything, we were just saying, everything's growing again, which is great, really. You know, just nature taking its course, really. I've got the wind mirror in there, you tell me off that. And so we're in the middle of like farming land, and we'll take you along to see what this eco trip is. Evidently, you see alligators, and look at this entrance to a ranch here. Look, it's that the Halls Burmont Ranch or something. So we're going to take you along, see what animals we see, wild pig, antelope type things, I think.
Let's just see what we see.
Well, we'll see what we see. On this straight road, I must say, it must be to and fro from somewhere because it's a through road because there's loads of lorries, but you can't overtake. And I don't know what the speed limit is, Steve, but I think you might be going over it.
It's 55.
And luckily he's got two hands on the wheel because he goes into layback mode and has one hand on the wheel, and then I keep singing, two hands on my wagon. And that means he's got to put two hands on the wheel. So I'm going to go right, which is south on the 31. And Babcock. Ooh, ooh. Eco tour. This is it. Got a big B, so I guess it's B for Babcock warning. At your own risk. Okay.
This is a drive and a half.
This is a drive up to the ranch. It's a 25-mile speed limit.
So I wonder, is this the American equivalent of Clarkson's Farm?
Clarkson's Farm, yeah. I don't think there's many visitors today. I mean, it's what, 8:47 in the morning. Our tour, we booked for 9:30. And I think they start them at 9 o'clock. Oh, you do take me to some great places, Steve.
Do I?
Yeah. That was a bit different. Doing some work on the farm. These are fields here. Growing something, but I don't know what. Preserve Tours, Babcock Ranch, it says. Ah, do you reckon that's just for the farm? All that stuff? God knows. How many acres is there here?
I don't know.
Thousands of acres.
Yeah.
We'll have to look it up.
In a quarter mile, your destination will be on the right.
Okay. Some buildings, I don't
know. He's got a cowboy hat on.
Oh my God, I'm going to see cowboys. Cowboys, real cowboys. Cool. We've got a nice bird, nice crane in there, I think. Well, we'll see what today brings. Bumpy, bumpy road.
Massive amounts of electricity stuff going on here.
That can't just be for the farm, no. Can it? Oh, look at all the solar power there they've got. I don't know if the camera's picking that up, but maybe there's a load of solar. Oh, maybe it's for that.
Yeah, maybe it's the other side of the road.
Oh,
as well.
Okay, so they would get a lot of money from all those solar powers, wouldn't the panels?
Yeah.
And they're selling back to the electricity companies or something.
Yeah, that's more as if what it is.
Yeah. Ooh, buses. Welcome. Cars and passenger vans this way.
Ooh, is this grass in the middle of the road?
Grass in the middle of the road.
Now, back in Devon, where we live, if I go on a road that has grass in the middle of it, I freak out because I think, oh my God, if I meet a car, it's usually one track and you can't, there's nowhere to, you know, if another car comes the other way, you can't get past. Look at the solar powers, though, the panels they've got. Wow. Look at them all.
There's hundreds
of them. I might ask that question. Oh, look at it. It's really full today, Steve.
Yep.
Park in some shade. There's plenty.
Yeah, I'll go over this side.
There's no one else here. Okay, right. Well, yeah, I mean, I think you just take your pick, really. We have arrived and.
Well, let's see what today holds.
Murdered. Well, I shouldn't swear. I didn't swear. Sorry. I have to bleep that out. We're probably going to get murdered or the chainsaw massacre's going to come.
No, I've been here before.
He's been here before. He came on his own once. I didn't want to come. But anyway, I'm doing it today.
So
I think sun hats and water.
Yeah.
Sunglasses.
And look around. Intriguing. They're actually made of barbed wire.
Yeah.
Barbed wire.
Is it? Spray painted.
So we had turned up early and we had some time to kill. So we decided to shoot into the gift shop, which was also where they took your money, or in our case, validated our prepayment for the tours themselves. The gift shop was interesting because, as well as the normal touristy type of gifts, such as t-shirts, mugs, jewellery, etc., it also had some of the items that were found on the site, including a very interesting cedar canoe, which was suspended from the ceiling, some bones that have been discovered there, and other things of interest to look around. Having done the gift shop, we decided to have a look around outside, and there was this film, Just Cool, starring Sean Connery, which was actually filmed on the Babcock Ranch. And in that film there was a cabin, and that cabin has remained on the site and is now repurposed as the museum. So the inside of the museum was very interesting. It had a series of exhibits that had nothing between the viewer, you know, so if you wanted to, you could touch them, but there were lots of notices saying, please don't touch. It had a number of items that were found on the site, for example, bones, some eggs, those sorts of elements. And it also had a number of photographs and facts about what had happened on the Babcock Ranch over time. All in all, it was well worth looking around and something that we hadn't expected. Thank you.
this area seem to be delightfully themed, with a sort of seaside meets western vibe, and it seemed to sell plants. Really nice area. And spot on time, our bus turned up, which was going to take us on an hour and a half tour of the Babcock Ranch.
I'll be driving, buggy's gonna rock and roll. I sweep in, goodness, pretty close to trees out there. So just keep the head, all body parts in the buggy.
Well, let's head out.
Again, thank you so much for coming out and sharing your day with us today.
So we're booked on the Swamp Buggy Eco Tour, and it's one of the more popular tours around this location. And there are also other specialist tours, like there's a monthly one for photographers, as well as a walking tour. We're going on a 90-minute excursion where we can see the natural Florida ecosystem and the animals that frequent it. The tour was well narrated as we went round on the bus, though the bus itself is a little bit on the bumpy side, but to be expected, and really, really interesting. On our tour, there were only four of us, so we had the opportunity to spread out across the bus and sit wherever we wanted to. There are no windows. The bus's windows have actually been taken out, and rubber protection has been added, against which you can lean. So we learnt a lot as we went through. When staring into a pond in order to try and spot some alligators, we learnt that the alligator can sink to the bottom and hold their breath for 2 hours, which was probably why we didn't see one in that particular location.
Well, we're already getting into our most diverse ecosystem, 900 plant varieties. This is called Pine Flatwoods, or Pine Flats. Prime wildlife habitat area.
This ranch is massive, 140 square miles. It's more than five times the size of the island of Manhattan. It's also the single largest purchase of land that's ever been made by the state of Florida.
They're definitely enjoying a little shade right now.
We learnt about the difference between the cow herder role that originally existed and how that migrated over time. We learnt about how cattle grids were placed on the property, which effectively saved a significant amount of time of the cow herder for rounding up, as they didn't have to dismount and open up the gates as they went round the ranch.
Heart-shaped crown, top of the head. Now they are migratory. They will go as far as Canada, Alaska, even Siberia, and they're monogamous.
And apparently the male will go to great lengths to attract the female, doing a dance, throwing branches around, generally sort of puffing himself up until the female takes interest in him. Thank you.
original commissary built in 1934, almost 90 years old. Out here, that's where the cowboys live with their families. End of an American quarter horse. A good quarter horse can run up to 55 miles an hour. And horses, you always move your cattle slow.
And it became very obvious that if there's some water around, then you were bound to find alligators, especially around this area. So we said Babcock made his money in lumber, and here is one of the last residues of that side of his income. The lumber was taken to places all over the world, for example, South Africa, where it was used to shore up the gold mines.
She's a big doe. That's a female doe. Here we go. So guys, we got American whitetails, then we got a little Osceola Derby. Now she's a hen. All right, she gets her name from Seminole Chief Osceola. Now, every color in the rainbow on about 6,000 feathers. They are Southwest Florida natives. Boys and girls are called Jennies and Jakes. Jennies mature into hens. She's a little hen. And then your Jakes mature into your Toms or Gobblers. Now, she's going to be a little subtler in color, where your Tom is going to be brilliant in color. Here's some more does. Oh, I got a little buck over here. He's got two little spikes coming on. Notice the velvet covering over the antlers. Remember, antlers shed. They grow and shed every year. There you go. Good morning. Early, early. Oh, I know. I think gorgeous. Oh, see everything. You're so skittish in this buggy. This is your trophy turkey right here. Osceola turkey. Here comes another one.
They'll just roll in the dusty dirt, cleans up their feathers, gets rid of any parasites they may have. Oh, okay. Wow. They're beautiful, dog. One of my favorite animals here.
The stubs sticking up around the tree are actually part of the root system, a remnant from the logging industry, which was used to pull trees through the swamp area. If you operated it, you got a premium pay package, because if anything went wrong, you either got seriously injured or killed. We stopped off for a small walk through some of the cypress trees, and these are the oldest trees on the site, with I think the oldest one being recorded at over 300 years old. and we were out for about 10 minutes looking at the cypress trees, which were fascinating. You don't really appreciate them until you see them close up. Anyway, we then got back on the bus and time to continue. So Hyde Cameras picked up the Florida panther, which was of great excitement, but the habitat of a breeding unit, which consists of one male and 2 to 5 females, is somewhere around about 200 square miles.
Let me introduce you.
This is Little Miss Dottie. She is an American alligator. She's our wildlife ambassador. This way you can be up close personal with a gator in a safe setting, okay? So fun facts, black and gold bands, they're unique to her just like your fingerprints unique to you. She has 3 eyelids, just like you and I, top and bottom. Third eyelid is called a nictitating membrane. When she goes underwater, a clear lens sweeps over the eye like swimming goggles.
Here's how you're gonna measure them. You're gonna measure from the nose to the eyes in inches and then convert to feet. Dottie's maybe 1.5 inches. She's about 1.5 feet long, okay?
And there's a dead end. There's no back, a flap goes down in the back. We call it like the dead end, kind of a pun.
It is.
If they're underwater and they open their mouth, at least water doesn't get down in the lungs. Gator teeth are like shark's teeth, though. When one falls out, another one grows in. Over 2,000 teeth in a lifetime.
Well, so...
No, much softer than I thought. Yeah.
This is where you get your gator meat, okay? It's all in the gator tail. When you get gator bites...
Yeah. Like chicken.
Yeah. It's all like chicken. To me, it's all about the dip. So I don't matter what it is. Chicken, turkey, you know, steak. Yeah. It's all about the dip. But definitely. Now, I do not go in the swamp and just catch gators for our tour department. I'm not that bold. So we got 6 gators in our department. Now, the state of Florida is extremely protective.
So going back to the film Just Calls, this drain is where there was one scene where Sean Connery had to go in and get a package from the drain, and when he went down there he beat a hasty retreat as there was an alligator in the drain, like there is today.
and this is a gator bite.
Okay. Let's just
pick
up.
So.
Oh, hot. Mustardy. It's like chicken.
Is this your first trip to the US?
No.
Oh.
Loads of times. Mm.
Well, what do you think of it?
Well, Florida's a great place to be now.
Oh yeah, we've been coming to Florida for years.
So, we've just been to the Babcock Ranch. Really recommend it. In fact, there was only four of us on the bus. So if you're going to go early in the morning, because that's when all the animals and alligators are all out. Evidently, come sort of lunchtime or even 11 o'clock, they all, find shade or something.
Go underwater
so you don't see them. So, a lovely little gift shop.
Nice little restaurant.
Yeah, we had some gator bites, which you'll see on this film. And I bought a Merry Christmas bauble with alligators and Babcock eco tours.
We have a Christmas tree, which isn't a Christmas tree.
Yeah.
It's an everyday tree. It's out all the year round.
Yeah.
And it's made of driftwood.
Yeah, we have it up all year round. And it doesn't have Christmas ornaments on. At Christmas, I put Christmas baubles on it. And we haven't got this quite right yet.
No.
Here we are. But it has a lot of, because we live in near the sea, we have a lot of seaside stuff. And at Easter, we put Easter stuff on, and Halloween, we put Halloween stuff on. So it's up all year round, because I do love a fairy light. And, so...
Which is totally irrelevant.
That bauble can go on when we get home. So yeah, this is totally irrelevant to the Babcock eco tour. But...
Which was great fun.
Which
was
great fun. How much was it, by the way?
About $50, I think.
For both of us?
Yes.
So you have to, we booked ahead, booked tickets, yeah. And do it online. And as I say, a nice gift shop, very nice, just lovely, very pleasant. It's not even a whole day. I mean, we got there, our tour was at 9:30.
Yeah. And hour and a half long.
It's
tour.
Now, well, we had some gator bites and a drink, and it's now 10 to 12. So it's, it's a morning or an afternoon. Jaunting up and down. Steve's driving. So, it was very good. So, catch you later.